almost always dumb and we're sorry.
Okay.
That's not true, though. We've had some really good ones.
We have.
Yeah.
We have.
Portions of this podcast are made possible through the patronage of great people like at Lonely Bob, Big Albie, and Goldafish. Since we are trying to grow our podcast in every way possible, even if you can't be a patron, you can still help us grow by liking, commenting, and subscribing to the podcast.
Welcome to the Rifles in Caramel 30 Minutes to Kill podcast.
You are listening to the Vices Interimo Show, 30 Minutes to Kill. More or Less. The incredible podcast with the unpronounceable name.
You are listening to the Vices Interimo Show, 30 Minutes to Kill, More or Less. A movie review podcast featuring horror, suspense, and psychological thrillers.
Did you say podcast?
Maybe.
Okay.
Maybe.
That's what I thought.
Anyhow, you can find us on iTunes, Stitchers, Podomatic, and just about anywhere. Type in V-I-C-I-S-I-N-T-E-R-I-M-O.
Is it Stitcher or Stitchers?
Stitcher.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think you said Stitchers.
I may be having a
check
problem.
Check out the podcast on Stitchers.
Great. It's going to be another one of those episodes, I see. I am your host, Michael Mad Saxon Jones, here with my lovely wife and co-host, Lori. Hi, Lori.
Hi.
We generally have four segments: a laid to rest, where we tie up loose ends from previous shows; a short review of a movie. We'll try to keep it short. I have a lot to say, but,
okay.
Well, we'll see.
That's good, because I don't think I do, but...
Well, wait till I get into it.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Anyhow, Garbage In, Garbage Out, where we talk about any other TV shows, movies, books, anything else we may have caught in the last week or so. And we end with a crawling chaos, a topic or factoid we have never talked about on the show before.
You got one?
I do.
And all right.
It's sometimes silly, sometimes serious, and most always chaotic.
Yeah.
Yeah, this one will be brief.
Or it's just absolutely dumb. And we're sorry.
Should that be part of our...
maybe
script?
I don't add that on to the almost always dumb and we're sorry.
Okay.
That's not true, though. We've had some really good ones.
We have.
Yeah.
We have. However, this is episode 383, and let's get into it, shall we?
Sure, why not? 383?
383.
Are you sure it's not 338?
Why am I smelling stinking smoke in here?
Because the neighbors are probably having a fire again.
Probably. All right.
You know, if you live 5 feet from somebody else's house, don't have a fire. I don't know. Ew, it smells like... Oh, man. I don't even want to say.
Briefly,
what is happening?
Last week we covered the movie Prodigy, The Prodigy, from 2019.
Prodigy's the band, remember?
Exactly. So, horror-ish thriller? I don't know. But anyhow, we covered that.
Yeah.
We covered an Italian village that turned into a ghost town. Well, that's actually something I placed. We actually, it was Mysteries of the Abandoned was the show.
Oh,
that we talked
okay.
about what we saw.
I was going to say, and whoa, we talked about that?
No, I found an episode.
I completely missed that.
You forgot. I found an episode of that to put up. So,
okay.
So that people could see.
Yeah. Okay.
And we talked about K-Gay, the new radio station that we found on our trip to India. We'll talk a little bit more about that later. But okay. I really don't think there's anything to talk about. I think we need to get right into talking about It Chapter 2, Filming the Impossible.
Okay.
with those crinkled eyebrows and stuff. That's kind of what
I'm... Filming the impossible.
Yeah, well, that's my my little subtitle for this episode.
Is that barbecue?
I don't know.
It went from smoke to, like, I don't know, slab of beef.
Okay.
Do you smell that?
I do.
It actually smells good for once.
Okay, well, that's
usually something. Usually our neighbors have such a disgusting barbecue. All of their barbecue smell comes over here, and it just smells like burnt, rotten meat or something.
That's awesome.
Tonight, this is actually working. So. Okay,
kind of ties in with what we're talking
not
about.
Not that I'm enjoying the house full of smoke, because I'm not.
Right.
But this ties in, pray tell.
Well, you know, the rotten meat and the whole nine yards, the grossness and stuff. Anyhow, okay. It Chapter 2.
Yes.
Preliminary thoughts.
Does it bother you that it's called Chapter 2?
It bothers me slightly.
Because, yes.
Why does it bother you?
Well, I guess because chapters, I think of being more than two.
Okay.
Like, oh, Chapter 2. All right, what's in Chapter 3? Well, nothing. Should have just been Part 1 and 2, or...
Yeah.
I don't know.
I do believe so. And my subtitle
it's just a weird,
Filming
I mean,
the Impossible.
It really doesn't matter, but it just bothers me.
I would have rather had a chapter. I can't believe I'm saying this. I generally would not say this, but I would rather have had a third part to this movie. But first, let's get to the good stuff.
Then chapter would have worked. Chapter 1, chapter 2, chapter 3.
What did you think of the movie as is without... Anything else?
Well, I really liked it.
You really liked it? Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
It was interesting because I kept hearing, oh, the second one is better than the first one. I would say, for me personally, I kind of like the first one better, but I mean, they're very consistent. Like, I don't think one is glaringly better than the other.
Okay.
I don't know.
I like
this. They were both really great. I mean, I loved them both. Okay. Together, they're great. It's a great movie.
Loved it. Super. I have both of them. We could sit down. We could watch them back to back if we so chose.
Right.
Which I think I'd like to do sometime soon.
Okay.
Okay. So we got all that out of the way. Loved it. Great movie. Blah,
yes.
Blah, blah. Okay. Now I'm going to rip into it.
Okay. There was a problem with the ending.
And I'm not going to say I'm going to rip into it.
I want to start at the ending first.
But having said everything like that, yeah. I did not like the second part as much as I liked the first part.
Right. Okay.
And I
We're on the same page then. I didn't know that. See, we haven't talked about it yet.
No, we haven't.
So I am not surprised because you and I are just too darn alike. Not always.
Not always. But...
So yeah, that's not surprising.
I would have rather had seen the chapter 3. I think that they went
a little too fast.
Way too fast. Yeah. Because the very first thing that I was going to say is, as much as I loved and enjoyed the movie, do not. Yes, that is Buck with a B.
Buck with a B. Sorry, he's on TV. We're not talking about that right now.
Nice. At any rate.
Yeah, Buck with a B has nothing to do with it or what we're talking about. He just happens to be on our television right now.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think we need to focus.
Okay, back to it.
Yes.
They absolutely flew through it.
They did.
Yeah.
So my absolute thing is do not bother analyzing. You're killing me.
Okay, hold that thought. Hello.
Hi.
Hi. You're breaking up on me. Sorry, I cannot hear you. I'm kind of busy. what I was hoping she'd have something funny or dumb to say. But that was disappointing.
Yes, that's very disappointing.
Okay, so we're back from Lady Gaga. Do you still do that?
I think so. Yeah, I do. Every now and then. Well, no, I got pinned on that with when YouTube, when it got uploaded to YouTube.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, YouTube, yeah.
Yeah, but anyhow, talking about it.
Yes.
On target now. Do not analyze that timeline.
No.
Because it's crazy after they took so much time and care with the first half of the story.
Yeah.
Episode one, with everything to do with the kids, how they got to where they were, the Easter eggs they put in. And not that there weren't Easter eggs in this one, too. But it went very quickly into 27 years later. Suddenly, in a single night, they're going to face off against Pennywise.
Right.
Or it.
Right. Well, I guess if you haven't read the book, it's believable and it makes sense. They came back to fight him, so let's get in there and do it.
It didn't feel awkward to you while you were watching it?
Well, we read the book. We know the book so well.
Yeah.
So, yeah, kind
of. I'm trying to look outside of that, looking at when it's daytime,
yeah,
when it's nighttime.
I'm trying.
But just watching the movie?
Because, yeah, they all get there at night, and they go to dinner, and they talk,
right.
and half of them say
the library
heck with
at
this.
8 o'clock at night.
Yeah.
And they go off and they have these adventures, and sometimes it's during the daytime, and sometimes it's during the nighttime.
Yeah,
you know, meet me in the library in just a little bit, and it's.
Well, it's and all the other ones go back to the motel because they're going to leave.
Right.
Motel, excuse me.
All of those.
Yeah, there was something. Yeah. It didn't show anybody, like, nighttime, we're going to bed now, okay, now it's morning.
And now it's the next
it was,
day.
Nighttime and daytime were kind of...
Just kind of fluid, and so we got a bunch of scenes.
Yeah.
This is where it fell down, where the first movie, I felt like we were watching a film from beginning to end.
Right.
Chapter 2, I got a lot of scenes, arguably, and I hate to say it, from the book, or...
Right.
From the movie, or condensed, or based on.
Right.
And again, we talk about this all the time, and we're complete hypocrites, because I say it's not fair to compare the book to the movie and whatever.
Yeah.
But oftentimes, you just can't help it if you're familiar with both things. I am, at the same time, very happy, though, that they left a lot out.
Yeah.
It just felt like to me everybody was underutilized. Had they had the time to put it into
a third movie,
they would have gotten even better performance. I loved everything that everybody did.
Yeah.
But we didn't see enough Pennywise.
Right.
It. Or we didn't see enough of the characters. We didn't see or get the sense of development.
Yeah, no one got enough time.
Yeah.
The character, young or old.
Young or old. And I did love seeing them overlap.
Yeah.
You know, and get to see the kids again years later and the, you know, the flashbacks and so on. But it just felt a little rushed.
Yeah. And it was a long movie.
And it was 3 hours long.
So, yeah, they should have added another hour or two and just chopped that sucker in half.
Paste it. A little bit more appropriately. So,
yeah.
Having said that again, I love the movie. It's great.
Yeah.
I think everybody should see it.
Yeah.
But
there's some scary scenes in there.
Absolutely. And you got scary scenes, though. You got, you know what I mean? There's not enough Bill Skarsgård. You got to see him a little bit in his arguably human form.
Right.
Do they call him Bob Gray? Do they even refer to him that in this one?
I don't think they do.
So, obviously, there's so many things. But here's the biggest thing that you pointed out to me, which is anybody that's seen and loved the movie.
Yeah.
They're in for, well, what are they in for when they read the book?
Lots of surprises and lots of story.
Yeah. as much as we've gone on about...
Is there something specific?
No, no, there wasn't something specific. Oh, okay. Well, just that
I was going to say something uncomfortable.
Well, there's that. Know. There's that in there, too. But, and there's a couple of secrets. Like I said, I wasn't sure how detailed they were going to go with, yeah. with the story.
So well, the book...
Is massive.
Man. Yeah, I mean, it gives you the history. There's so much flashing back.
The history of the town. The history yeah. of each of the characters.
Yeah.
The histories of other characters that have never even just passed out through the town.
Yeah.
Histories of people that, you know, went off to Haven, that went off to other places and yeah. stuff. There's so many things that tie so deeply into the SKU, the Stephen King universe, the mythos and stuff that's all woven through all of his yes. stories. You get all of that. You saw little pieces of that with the mural in the first chapter yep. and stuff. And you see the mural
yeah,
again.
Yeah, there
this
was
one.
Lots of little things in there.
There were so many little Easter eggs and things to enjoy that I'm glad to see that they left a few things out, that there are some big surprises
yeah.
in the book. But... Having said that, anybody that watched the movie,
mm-hmm.
I couldn't recommend everybody to read the book.
Right.
First of all, that's a lot of reading.
I was going to say, you have to be super dedicated to get through the book.
Yeah. Having said that, though, you can...
And you have to be interested in things that almost feel like it's not even related.
Right. That only maybe kind have of. A passing thing.
But... You get a lot of Mike's family history.
Yeah.
His Absolutely. Dad and
yep, his and the things that his dad went through.
Yeah.
The things that
I remember for a while, I was like, "Wait, what am I? What is this book again?" Because it becomes something else.
So, having said that, though, since the first movie came out, there is an excellent audio version out there that you can enjoy.
Yeah.
You might even be able to find parts of it or some of it in on YouTube. It might be out there, or whatever. You can certainly pick it up at your local bookstore if you still have a bookstore, and I'm sure you can find it on Amazon. But if reading it's going to be a chore,
mm-hmm.
and you have the aptitude or the dedication to listen to podcasts, you certainly would probably, you would most likely...
certainly or probably.
You would most likely enjoy listening to the audiobook,
yeah.
and that might be an easier way to get the whole thing. But it's not going to be what you saw in the movie.
No, it isn't.
It's another one of those times where I thought they did a good job catching the flavor of it. But
yeah.
for me, part two is not as strong as part one.
Right.
Yeah. I would have liked to have seen a part three.
Yeah.
Yeah. I don't know. Did we groan? Did we groan on? Did we drone on too long about nothing? I'm sure the audience
We're
is groaning at this
groaning,
point.
They're groaning, yeah.
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
So,
but just real quick, special effects.
Awesome.
Good. Okay.
Yep.
Scary. That, like we said, there were some scary things in there.
Scary things in there for sure.
Oh my gosh, when he wants to come through that glass.
Oh.
That's scary. That was the scariest part to me.
There, a lot of things like that. You're going to get
the
scenes.
Acting.
And I guess I could see why somebody that wasn't necessarily wholly invested in the story
yeah.
would think that part two was better.
Okay.
And if you do, that's not a problem, not a condemnation of your
choice. Well, now, can I tell you, I heard someone say that it was a little long and slow and, like, all that reminiscent stuff of them thinking about back when they were a kid. Maybe it was a little much.
We keep going back through to then every time something like that comes up, I think about your experience in going to watch Halloween. Which Halloween did you go for? We won't go into that again. But, you know, most people aren't into that. They're just in it for the entertainment.
Yeah.
And so that's it.
It was Halloween 8.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. So I think...
people were just not even interested in what I had to say.
Yeah, they just wanted to see the
like,
kills.
They're like, no, I'm here to just see how Michael Myers is going to kill people. I'm just here for the killing. I don't care about the story.
Yeah.
I mean...
Sadly, that's the way.
Yeah.
So, anyhow, getting back to this movie.
Michael Myers has a story!
And
I don't mean Rob Zombie's.
No, we're not going there.
Don't even.
We're not going there. So,
no.
Number on It, Chapter 2.
Messed it up, Rob. What?
It, Chapter 2. What's your number?
A 4.5.
Okay, 4.5. I was waiting to see if you were going to say 4.75.
I almost said 4.25.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I was going to say 4.5, but yeah, okay. Yeah, it just, for us or for me, it just kind of missed the mark.
Okay.
Having said that, I loved it. It was great. I would recommend it to most. If anybody's seen one, you got to see two.
Yeah. What'd you think of the actors? All the actors they chose to play them as adults.
Great.
Pretty good, huh?
Yeah, absolutely. There was nothing that I could pick apart like that.
Yeah.
There was nothing. No. We'll just leave it at that.
All right.
Garbage in, garbage out. So, we went on vacation. We went to Indio.
We did.
We were only there for about 3 days. And every single day we went to the movies.
Yes, we did.
We talked about that last episode. But what did we see? We saw It Chapter 2. We saw Ad Astra. And then we saw It Chapter 2.
Yes, we did.
So, we went twice to see the same movie. And had
like,
plenty of time to
and
think
I,
about it.
I really like seeing movies twice that close together.
Yeah?
I do.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Well, let's talk about Ad Astra, though, because this is garbage in, garbage out.
Yeah.
What did you think about that? Brad Pitt in space.
Yeah.
Yeah?
I really enjoyed it.
It's a tough movie.
I love going to space.
I have... Since The Expanse...
It was a philosophical...
Well,
story.
Right from the name. I mean, the name made no sense to me until you told me it was a Latin reference, which I should have picked up on or what have you. But I, what I was starting to say, though, is I have, since The Expanse, especially, for whatever reason.
You have a very high standard now, do you?
I was actually going to say, I won't say a fear of space, but it made me take... more seriously, which is, this is so stupid. But
no, it isn't.
It's made me take more seriously the idea of traveling to space and like what's involved in that. And like, you know, we've seen so much sci-fi and so much that we enjoy and this and that or whatever that like for me there was a point, there was a disconnect where like, oh yeah, just hop in a spaceship and just go and this.
Well, that's Star Trek.
But then
you know what I mean? Like, Star Trek looks very comfortable and
it's just
everything
like
is spacious and clean and wonderful.
But with movies like this or with Gravity or anything like that.
The reality of the claustrophobic.
Well, not just that, but like how the only resources you have are the resources you take with you.
That's right.
And so.
And we've seen what the toilets look like.
Getting back to this is true.
They're like
at the
a
science
vacuum
museum
cleaner
there.
Attached to a bowl. Go ahead.
So, anyhow, having said all that, how representative do you feel the trailer for the movie was?
Okay, I had to remember what the trailer was like.
I
didn't figure it was an action film.
Okay.
So that was the only scene it showed, but I just assumed it was not.
So I knew nothing about this?
Yeah, I didn't think, because someone else before we went and saw it said, oh, let us know how it is, because it looks like, it's like an action film. I never thought that that's what it was going to be.
Okay.
In spite of that
small clip?
Yeah.
Because
there was only a couple vehicles chasing each other.
Right.
That was so well done, by the way. Oh, my gosh. I kept thinking, oh, man, if you crash, you're on the moon. There's no gravity. I mean, there's gravity. Minimal gravity.
A third of what you normally weigh.
Yeah. If there's no gravity, that would be a problem. They wouldn't be on the moon.
Exactly.
But no, with that lack of gravity, I kept thinking, if something happens, you'd have a pretty good chance of survival.
So what we're talking about, if you haven't seen it, if you haven't seen the clip or the,
I'm assuming you'll have it in the show notes.
I'll put it there, of course, yes, so you can see it. But there's one particular scene where my general concept of it was Brad Pitt's going to the moon, and there's some pirates there that are on the moon.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that was the big things that stood out to me.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm gesturing so much with my hands tonight. Nobody can see that but you. But anyhow.
I'm looking at you.
So I thought, oh my gosh, so it's going to be kind of like an action thing because he's going there and somebody's
so
gone rogue. Not necessarily. I was up for anything.
Okay.
But that is what stood out to me. And I thought, oh, well, there's going to be some things. And then there's a clip, an audio clip, where Brad Pitt is being asked, well, I've done everything you asked me to. And a voice that's not his, or has been disguised, says, not everything. And it's like, oh, what's that? And it says, I don't know, something like I said, it'll keep you guessing until the end. And I thought, oh man, this is going to be like some kind of mystery thing or whatever.
Right.
Or, I don't know. So I had a lot of expectations built up as to what it might be.
Right.
But at the same time, I didn't have any idea. I was ready to accept anything.
Well, before we went and saw it, I did read the synopsis, I guess, the plot line.
Mm-hmm.
And it does, it gave quite a bit away.
Oh.
But, well,
that's
no.
That's not fair.
Well, no, I can't. Well, no, I mean, I guess it didn't. It's because you find out right away what he's going out there to do. He's going out there to find his father.
Right.
And, like, that's pretty much all it says in the synopsis, is that this man goes out, you know, goes out in search of his father out to the edge of the galaxy.
Yeah.
So it didn't sound, it sounded quite dull, actually, you know.
Okay.
It's in space, so I was all in, because I can't get enough of it. So, I mean, I was going to be happy with it regardless, probably.
Okay.
But yeah, I mean, it didn't have a big exciting story. I feel like it just had a very strong philosophical.
It was definitely an atmospheric piece.
Yeah.
When you got said and done and stuff, it was very atmospheric, and
very,
yeah.
Yeah, if you're bored with silence and watching a ship float across the screen for 30 seconds, then it's probably not
it's
the
not
movie
for
you.
Okay.
Yeah, I loved it, because I could just float around in space all day.
Okay.
All
right,
and
well,
the story didn't bother me. I mean, you have to kind of, it's a thinker.
Yeah.
So, you know, if you're tired, you shouldn't, well, I mean, unless you could really get into it and think about it, mm-hmm. then I wouldn't recommend it.
Okay.
Or if you want an action adventure, you want to eat your popcorn and shut your brain off.
Not the one.
Not the movie.
Okay.
If you're a Brad Pitt fan, should go see it.
So 180 degrees from that.
Yes.
We've started watching Fear of the Walking Dead this past season. The season's now ended. We're about to go into The Walking Dead.
Yeah.
I
had to quit following them on Facebook because it's spoilers all over the place.
Okay, a couple of episodes in, what did you think of Fear of the Walking Dead? This season of it, so far?
So far, so good.
Okay.
I was a little, maybe I was just tired, but I was having a little bit of trouble following the story or what was happening.
Okay.
Was it me?
It was maybe you.
It might be me. I'm suffering a little brain fog lately.
It was probably you then. But I thought it was good. I thought we enjoyed it. I thought we talked about this a little bit, which we normally didn't.
Yeah,
which
I like all the new. I like all the new characters.
So my question becomes,
what
is this good because the other seasons weren't as good for us?
Well, I mean, the characters make the show.
Okay.
Any show, any movie, any story. It's all about the characters.
Okay.
Season 1, 2, 3, I don't know, Madison and Nick and, I could have stopped watching that anytime.
Okay.
But I didn't care for them. There was a lot of other characters I didn't care for. And as we've gone along, a lot of the characters I don't like got kicked off.
It's like Z Nation.
The
characters you didn't like that died off quick. And
Z Nation was... That was the most amazing thing ever. Because, yeah, every single person I didn't like got killed off, and all my favorites lived to the very end. How often does that happen?
Not very often.
So, Fear the Walking Dead is pretty close. There's still some dang annoying people on there.
Indeed.
I like it.
Okay, but again, my question was because of the previous season sucking, or just...
No, the characters.
Okay, you like the characters.
I think so.
Fair enough.
I mean, it's, you know, the writing can be a little corny, but, you know, the writing on Walking Dead now is a little corny, too.
Okay.
Not corny. I mean, not the big picture.
Right.
I love the Whispers, and I love Alpha, and
right.
I love all of that. But you could tell there's different writers. Like, some of the dialogue and some of the situations, it's a little comical,
okay.
I guess.
Okay.
Not in a hilarious, ha-ha way, but
dark
it's
comedy.
Just like, what?
Okay.
No, just kind of corny. I don't know. But Fear the Walking
Too
Dead...
Too on the nose.
Yes.
Okay.
And Fear the Walking Dead to me has always been that way.
Okay, I gotcha.
Yeah, but so I'm actually, I would like Fear the Walking Dead to get a little darker maybe and a little more realistic.
Okay.
But I don't think it's going to.
All right, fair enough.
I don't know.
Well, there's a third series coming.
It's enjoyable enough. I knew it.
So.
I knew it way before I knew. I mean, it was kind of obvious.
Okay.
Well, because Walking Dead, I think, is Walking Dead.
Days are numbered. Well, they ended the comic book.
Yeah.
So I went back, and that's something else we did while we were in Indio. I got, I went to Palm Desert, I think. I visited a comic book shop there.
Yes.
And you got a free comic on your birthday.
Yay.
And I picked up the final issue of the
Do you think the guy was surprised I picked a Punisher comic?
I don't know. Probably not. We had a nice talk, and we loved comics.
Because you know what? He told me since it was my birthday and I could pick out anything I wanted out of the store.
Any new comic?
He said, pick something fun, pick something different, and just totally out of the, out of your normal, I forgot how he said it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, so I pick up a Punisher.
Yeah, which is within your wheelhouse.
That is my thing. He probably thought that
you went 180 degrees outside your comfort zone, not realizing you slid right into the stuff.
Yeah.
Because you used to collect, what did you collect, Punisher, or did you collect?
Wolverine.
You collected Wolverine, I know.
Yeah.
Okay. Well,
that's the only one I seriously collected.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Fair enough. Anyhow.
Yeah.
Moving on then to Crawling Chaos.
Yeah, okay. We didn't watch anything else?
Solved my Rubik's Cube.
Oh my gosh, that's right. Yay.
So,
this
not
is
without help.
Crawling Chaos?
That's my Crawling Chaos. Without.
Well, that's something we've never talked about before because you've never done that before.
I haven't. I mean, I've solved it before by popping that corner block off and pulling
it off. That's cheating.
Well, some people might argue. But
you solved it for real.
I solved it for real, but with the help of a Wired article. I will include the link in the show notes.
People who are stuck with the Rubik's Cube?
For people that want to actually solve, to learn to solve it.
Okay.
Because it is a matter of algorithms and stuff. There's ways to do it, obviously.
Yeah.
Nobody does it just automatically. I mean, whether you know you're doing the algorithms or not or whatever, there's only so many ways that thing is going to scramble or unscramble.
Right.
There's millions of combinations, but it boils down to eventually you're going to need to make these moves, and it's a matter of memorizing them and so on. But anyhow.
It's cool that you got so into it.
Well, and then you got me that stupid 4x4, which was just so simple and easy,
man,
that there's only like 4 billion combinations. Not billions, but it's ridiculously complex.
I thought it would be easier because there's only 4.
So did I, too. It's deceiving in the fact that it looks like
harder?
I've got it myself just without algorithms, without whatever, yeah. I've got it down to one flipping corner that is not right. So.
Well, that's a quarter of, I mean, it's.
There's only four blocks. Well,
it's a 4x4, so one corner is like a quarter of one side.
Is a quarter of it that is not solved. But I got it that close, and I cannot do that one now. So I'm going to have to learn that, too. Well, I thought, you know, I never wanted to pick up one of those because, it, you know, I thought, oh, well, I'm doing a 3x3. Why on earth would I want to go back to a 2x2? That would just be our 4x4.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's not simple. Or 2x2. It is 2x2. Yeah. It's,
whatever, there's four blocks on each side.
Anyhow, that's the ridiculous crawling chaos for this week. I'm sitting there looking at my Rubik's Cube you bought me for, what was that, Christmas?
That's
was
amazing.
A birthday? How long have they?
I think Mom got you that one.
No, okay. Mm-hmm. Well, it was...
Because it was expensive.
Yeah, I mean, it is Rubik's.
It's a nice one with a little stand and all that.
Yeah. And it is...
Your little 2x2 I picked up at a thrift store for $1.
Okay, well...
Yeah, but it was brand new.
It's worth every penny of that.
It was brand new. Somebody bought it and took it home and went, what the... And then they threw it in the thrift store bag.
Yeah, I could see. They probably thought it was easy and going to be super simple and ridiculous as that is. This one itself, though, I did solve at least the bottom two layers of it.
Yeah.
I couldn't finish that final top one. And then our nephew came over, grabs it and picks it up and like flip, flip, flip. And he's like, oh, were you doing that? And I'm like, oh, I'm not going to get that back. at any rate, there is a Wired magazine did a actual, I don't know, an article, an essay on the fastest solves for the cube. And the person doing the article learned how to solve the cube himself.
Yeah.
And I guess a lot of people requested, hey, why don't you show us what you learned? So there's an entire video from Wired Magazine that I will include in the show notes anyhow. I don't know. We're probably going on
it's
long
funny
on
that
this
so
one.
Many people are into it.
Still. Well, it's come back again. It's kind of had a resurgence from the... From
well,
the 80s
when it came out when we were kids,
oh my
it was,
gosh.
Everybody obviously had one, but I never...
No, never?
Like, no, I just played with it a few times and I was like, oh, okay, yeah, that's...
You just stuck to your Pyraminx or your...
Oh, I was aces at doing the Pyraminx. I could do that and I could solve it in about, I mean, it's not going to sound impressive, especially these days when people could do a Rubik's Cube in 5 seconds.
Yeah.
But the Pyraminx, I think the quickest I ever did it was like 25 minutes.
Oh, okay.
But it's doable. Something about the triangles.
Yeah.
Just
made more sense to your brain?
Absolutely. The square and all of those, that just really messed me up.
Well, there's so many ridiculous shapes and stuff now.
I mean, the Pyraminx only has 4 sides.
I said we were going to stop, and we keep
and
talking.
And I like how it felt in my hand, too. Twisting those little top ones, the ones on the ends.
Well, now
stuff.
I know what to get you for a nostalgia gift.
Yeah, they're making them again.
Yes, they are.
Yeah.
All right. I think we killed it.
Yeah, we did.
And as always, before I end the episode, I want to absolutely thank our patrons at Lonely Bob, Big Alvy, and Gold of Fish. And to anybody else, we of course have a Patreon account which you could support us. But you can also support us just by liking, commenting, and subscribing to the podcast. Give us any thoughts on topics of movies that you'd like to see us cover. And we'll talk to you next time.
Yeah.